The purpose of this, the studies that we did in this paper that was recently accepted in JCI Insight, was to use our kidney on a chip, or kidney microphysiological system, which is shown here, manufactured by Nordis, prepared in my lab, is to actually look at understanding the toxicity of an antibiotic called Polymyxin B. So Polymyxin B is an antibiotic that's been around for decades. What happened, though, is when it first was approved and went into the clinics, what was found is that while it was very effective against gram-negative bacteria, it turned out to be highly toxic to the kidneys, inducing AKI, or acute kidney injury, in the majority of patients that were treated with it. Because of this, Polymyxin B fell out of favor as a frontline therapy for treating infections, but it is still commonly used for multi-drug resistant therapies compared to standard antibiotics. But it still has these high degrees of nephrotoxicity. But the mechanisms are poorly understood. And so what we set out to do was to use our kidney on a chip to actually model what happens in human kidneys. And so our kidney on a chip is a microphysiological system which is populated with primary human renal epithelial cells, which we isolate and prepare in my lab from donor kidneys, from waste tissue. And when we went about doing these studies, looking at the historical literature, it was suggested that reactive oxygen species were the mechanisms of toxicity for Polymyxin B. And what we found using the system, using very high concentrations, that we could replicate those findings. But when we went actually use doses of Polymyxin B, which are much more in the range of what you'd see in patients treated with the drug, is what we saw is that reactive oxygen species were not a major player. And then what we did is actually looked at global transcriptomics in the microphysiological systems using RNA-seq. And what we did is what we identified was a very unique response, which was induction of cholesterol synthesis. And this is something which is completely unexpected, but there actually have been accounts in the literature of patients in the ICU with acute kidney injury that actually have elevated cholesterol in their urine. So it actually, in many ways, makes sense about our findings. And so what we also did is we partnered with Northern Antibiotics, which is a company in Helsinki, Finland, founded by Marty and Timo Vara. And what they are doing is actually developing new classes of antibiotics based on the Polymyxin B structure. Namely, the drugs we're looking at was NAB741 and NAB739. Both these drugs have been shown to be safe in preclinical studies, and NAB739 remains in clinical or preclinical development, whereas NAB741 was licensed to Spiro Therapeutics and actually has completed a phase one clinical trial in healthy volunteers. And we compared the toxicity of Polymyxin B to the northern antibiotic compounds. What we found is that we actually recapitulated the safety of what was seen in patients in that NAB741 and NAB739 were non-toxic to the kidney chips. While we saw over 800 genes changed in expression in response to Polymyxin B, only 18 were changed in response to NAB739, and I believe only one was changed with NAB741. This is actually very good technology for validating what happens in humans. This research has been funded by NCATS, or National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences, and this was part of their Organs on Chips initiatives to recapitulate or model human organ function using human cells. And this initiative was to come up with alternatives to animal testing to look at drug efficacy and toxicity. And the findings we found with Polymyxin B, and more importantly, the NAB/SPR741 compounds, is that this technology can be used to prove that new chemical entities can be safe in humans. And so this is, as a toxicologist, this is very satisfying to me because this represents the three R's of toxicology with regard to animal testing. We can reduce, refine, and replace. So for example, in the case of reduce, we can actually, from a single animal, populate hundreds of chips. And with refine, we can actually look at appropriate species as well as humans in terms of toxicology. And of course, the ultimate goal would actually be to replace animals, and that would be part of the so-called human on a chip. At Harvard, as well as Northern Antibiotics with Timo and Marty Vara, and what we actually did was look at multiple different angles. Not only did we look at the transcriptomics with RNA-seq, but we also worked with the lab of Levin Zhu in medicinal chemistry to actually show that cholesterol synthesis and excretion was increased in response to polymyxin treatment. And we also, in terms of understanding the mechanism of toxicity, working with Bill Atkins' lab in medicinal chemistry, we also were able to show quite clearly using surface plasmon resonance that the interaction of polymyxin B compared to NAB741 was significantly different with high binding of polymyxin B, whereas there's greatly decreased binding of NAB741 or SPR741 in comparison to polymyxin B. And so this is a research study which spans from basic biochemistry all the way up to understanding what is going to be occurring in the clinic. And we're really excited about working with Spiro Therapeutics and Northern Antibiotics in the future, where we actually are hoping to include the data generated in the study as part of an eventual NDA or new drug application for SPR 741.